Hey everyone, the 12th and 13th centuries were times of great upheaval in the Indian subcontinent, characterized by invasions and conquests that reshaped the region's cultural and intellectual landscape. Among the most devastating events of this era was the destruction of Nalanda University, one of the world's oldest centers of learning, at the hands of Bakhtiar Khilji. Today, let's know about the destruction of Nalanda University, Bakhtiar Khilji's devastating conquest, and a tragic end of a scholarly haven. Let's start the video, but before that, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and like this video. Bakhtiar Khilji, also known as Muhammad Bakhtiar Khilji, hailed from the Khilji tribe of Turkish origin. Initially serving under the Ghurid rulers, he quickly rose through the ranks due to his military acumen. His career in India began in the late 12th century during a period of Ghurid expansion. Khilji was appointed as a military general and later as a governor of Bengal, a position that he leveraged to launch further campaigns in northern India. Upon securing Bengal, Bakhtiar Khilji turned his attention to the fertile and wealthy regions of Bihar. His campaigns were marked by swift and brutal tactics aimed at consolidating Ghurid control and expanding their territories. It was during one of these campaigns that he set his sights on Nalanda. Founded in the 5th century, Nalanda University was not merely a place of learning but a symbol of India's intellectual heritage. It attracted scholars and students from across Asia, offering a diverse curriculum that included Buddhist studies, logic, grammar, medicine, and philosophy. The university boasted a vast library with countless manuscripts, making it a repository of ancient knowledge. In around 1193 century, Bakhtiar Khilji led a raid on the Magadha region where Nalanda was situated. The reasons behind his attack on the university are not entirely clear, but it is widely believed to be part of his broader strategy to assert dominance and cripple the cultural and intellectual heart of the region. Khilji's forces descended upon Nalanda with ruthless efficiency. The university was set ablaze and its precious manuscripts were consigned to the flames. According to historical accounts, including the Tabakat-e-Nasiri by Minhaj-e-Siraj, the fires raged for several months, reducing vast collections of knowledge to ashes. Many scholars were killed and those who survived were forced to flee. The devastation was comprehensive. Not only were the physical structures of Nalanda destroyed, but the attack also shattered the intellectual and cultural fabric of the region. The loss of the library was particularly catastrophic, erasing centuries of accumulated wisdom and scholarship. The destruction of Nalanda was a severe blow to Buddhism in India. The university had been a major center of Buddhist learning, and its loss marked the beginning of a decline in Buddhist influence in the region. Monks and scholars who survived the attack were dispersed, and many sought refuge in neighboring countries, taking with them whatever fragments of knowledge they could salvage. The attack on Nalanda was not just a physical destruction, but a symbolic assault on knowledge and learning. The university had represented the pinnacle of intellectual achievement in the ancient world, and its loss was felt far beyond the borders of India. The decline of such a pivotal institution marked the end of an era and the onset of a period of intellectual darkness in the region. Bakhtiar Khilji's legacy is forever tainted by his role in the destruction of Nalanda. While he may have been a successful military general, his actions led to an irreplaceable loss for humanity. The ruins of Nalanda stand today as a stark reminder of the vulnerability of cultural and educational institutions to the ravages of war and conquest. The story of Bakhtiar Khilji and the destruction of Nalanda University is a poignant chapter in the history of India. It underscores the profound impact that military conquests can have on cultural and intellectual heritage. As we reflect on this tragic event, it serves as a powerful reminder of the need to protect and preserve the repositories of human knowledge for future generations. Well, that's it for today. I hope you're liking Nerdy's discoveries. Can't wait for the next video to learn more and be fascinated about. See you on the next. Bye.